to come to our house on purpose, is where this was. And I'm like, who's knocking on the door? Who's letting their Girl Scouts go and bang on the door this late? And, you know, I'm thinking, but if it's Girl Scout, I'll go get some cookies at least. So I opened up the door, and it was a couple. And I'm thinking, I know where they live. Why are they at my door? First thing I think of is, oh, they're having marital problems. What a ding-dong. I'm thinking they have marital problems, you know, and they want us to help. So I was immediately inconvenienced. They said, can we come in? Sure. We're in our pajamas, you know. We're sitting there, sitting around the couch, and we're all just looking at each other. And I said, bless you. I said, why are you here? And they just kept looking at us. I said, why are you here? And they looked at each other, concerned. God told us to bring this to you, and we were going to do it tomorrow, but he said, bring it to you tonight. And they put that check in my hand. And I looked at it, and I was like, oh, Lord God, that's the car payment. I put it in my pocket, and I said, honey, get up. Show our guests some respect. What would you all like to drink? You want something to eat? We'll make you some steak and some chicken. What do you want? Shrimp? Do I need to go get something? No, we can't stay. Are you sure? You want to spend the night? We'll have a slumber party. We'll put on toys. We'll put on cars, whatever. We'll just have a good time. Popcorn? What are we going to do? Let's snuggle. Anyway, so you know, we didn't have steak or shrimp, but we could buy a little bit. No, I'm teasing. So, you know, God blessed us, and we had that amount, and that was fine. But the thing is, we had gotten in such a bad... I don't know if you've ever been there before. I'm closing with this, but where it's just like, wow, you know, you caught up, but then it's like, here it comes again, the next month. Remember? Here we go again. Well, this was again years ago. Thank God that's not ever going to happen again, but it happened this time, and here's what happens. They're calling. They're collecting. We're traveling. We're doing our best. We're going to churches that are nowhere near bringing in. What we're like, are you kidding me? What happened like last year? Just on average, you know, you start. There's a business side to ministry, and we have expenses, you understand? And so here's what's going on. I'm thinking, are you kidding me? It's like there's nothing close to what we need to take care of our house and all this other stuff. And so we started finding out from our neighbors, hey, there were some really nice people here looking for you. I'm like, yeah, what do they look like? Well, they were just asking where you were, and we're like, well, we don't know. We just knew they traveled a lot. Every time they came to possess our car, we were on a ministry trip. I know it was making them mad because I found out later that they came from Arkansas. And so they come all the way from Arkansas to catch us, and then they'd have to go all the way back to Arkansas where we couldn't. And they're like, where are these people? Well, we weren't trying to evade them, you understand? But we just were always gone whenever they came to collect. And then I'd be talking to the banker. Well, I finally got this call that said, Reverend Hoskins, this is so-and-so. Would you please call? Reverend Hoskins? Oh, man. What a bad steward of the ministry, you know? I know some of y'all haven't been there. Stop judging me. But still, Reverend Hoskins, something there told me to call. And I called it, and I said, this is Jay Hoskins. She goes, Reverend Hoskins, thank you for returning my phone call so quickly. I am supposed to come and get your car. And I said, yeah, I understand. I said, is there something we can do to work out? I mean, well, yeah. And then they said this certain amount. And I'm like, is there something else we can do to work it out? You know? And we've been very lenient with you. We've come several times to come collect the vehicle, but you haven't been home. She goes, where have you been? I said, well, we're in traveling ministry. She goes, oh, you're not a pastor. Okay, so you're that makes sense. You're traveling. All right. She goes, well, when can we come and get the car? I said, listen, what can we work out here? She says, listen, I'm high enough up. I can pull some strings. I'm a Christian too. I want to help you, and I believe in you. I'm like, you don't know me, but thank you. She says, I can do so much, but my hands are tied to a certain degree. You're going to need at least X amount of dollars to come in. She goes, when do you go out and minister again? Or what can you do? Can you call an uncle? Can you call this? Can you put a hit on somebody? You know, whatever. So you're like, how can you get this money? And I said, we're going out and we're ministering again this Sunday. It was on Friday. I said, we're leaving tomorrow. We're going out and we can, you know, we'll catch back up with you on Monday afternoon. We'll come back in. and we'll take care of it. She goes, okay. I said, this is how much I need? She said, yes. And I said, all right. She goes, listen, I'm in agreement with you. Come on now, repossession people are in agreement and praying with me. First of all, it's stupid to be in that situation, but thank God that it was a lady that was in agreement with us. And then I told my wife, I said, this is what's happening. This is the amount we need. And she goes, oh, Lord, you know where we're going this Sunday? And our heads just dropped. Because we've been there before, but it wasn't the most, you know what I mean? It wasn't like, you know, it was like a mission field in essence, okay? And so we go and we minister and we poured our heart out. I mean, we just gave it like we always do, 150%. We just poured it out. And then the next thing you know is we're driving home Sunday night from that meeting, because we're about 5 hours away. We drove back home because we had to meet this lady. And God is my witness, I had forgotten about the check. We were so drunk in the spirit. We were just laughing, having a good time. Woo, glory to God. And forgetting about everything. And then she goes, ha, 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 ha. What about the check? And I said, oh, I forgot about that. I pulled it out. I opened it up. And I looked at it. And I just handed it to her. It was $500 more than what we needed. You don't understand. It was not, this church never has ever been able or in a position to bless us like this. But I thank God. I wanted to call her up. Okay, so anyway. That I wanted to say, you want to be a partner with our ministry? Pray for us, honey. Be in agreement everywhere we go. I knew she had car faith. Anyway, so, long story short, I call her. She called me the next day. She goes, Mr. Hoskins. I said, yes. Yes. She goes, oh. I said, yeah. She goes, can we meet to come pick up your car? And I said, no, I'm afraid that's not going to happen. She goes, what? I said, I got all the money. It came in. I said, you were in agreement with us? It all came in. She goes, really? I said, now come on now, are you believing or not? She said, well, this is good news. She goes, well, come and meet me right away. I said, all right. And so we met her, and you know, it was very business at that point. But you know, I'm telling you, up until that point, God's grace was really on that. Praise the Lord. So He's looking out for us. He's looking out for you. If He tells you to do something, do it. Don't compromise. Just bow your head and shut your eyes. Hear me. Would you come here for just a moment? Father, we thank You for the word that went forth tonight. We will not compromise. We will obey. Lord, we won't just thrust out a little. We're here to launch out. Lord, I thank You for whatever You tell us to do. We have the faith, the unction to do it. Lord, each and every one of these precious ones, each and every one that's been coming, each and every one that's here for the first time, or those that have come every single service, Lord, I declare and decree over their situations, in their finances, I declare right now, breakthrough in Jesus' name. I declare an abundance, a harvest coming to them, assigned to them, just like the fish were assigned to Peter. Yeah, Lord, I will say that. There will be times He will tell you to launch to a place that you're not comfortable to launch to. Sometimes that's in the form of sowing. Sometimes that's in the form of doing. Sometimes that's in the form of saying or physically going and doing something, and it's not comfortable. But when He tells you to launch out, no. When He tells you to do, do it. That's where the water turns to wine. Thank You, Lord. I'm going to tell you right now, stop seeking a breakthrough. Start living in the broken through era. You have been broken through. Things are broken over you right now. All over this place, you may say, I want to rededicate my life to the Lord Jesus. I have had areas in my life where I've been compromised. I no longer want to have compromising effects, compromised harvests in my life. I'm ready to launch out into the deep, and I'm ready to take on everything that You have for me, Lord. When I count to three, if you'll be honest tonight and say, yeah, there's been stuff in my way. There's been stuff I've allowed to come up. But I want to get rid of it tonight. I'm going to pray for you. When I count to three, I want you just to simply lift your hand with the others that will lift their hands in here. I'm just going to ask you to join those that lift theirs. You may say, peradventure, you've never asked Jesus to be the Lord of your life, never asked Him to be Savior, and you want to make Him the Lord of your life tonight. When I count to three, you as well lift your hand with these others that will lift theirs. You may say, I'm just basically, Lord, I'm at a place right now at a crossroads. I go to church all the time, I pray, I read the Word, but you know, I've just been out of fellowship with you on a daily basis. Like what Pastor Jay was saying about walking in the cool of the day, I've been kind of hiding off to the side, not meeting with you and fellowshipping with you, and tonight, I want to turn that back around, I want to get back into fellowship with you. When I count to three, child of God, if that's you, I want you to lift your hand to it. I'm just going to simply pray for you as well. All over this place, find any one of those invitations. One, two, three. If you would just momentarily keep the hand up with heads bowed, eyes closed, hands lifted. I see all those hands. Thank you, Jesus. Now with those hands lifted, I'm going to pray for you, but all of us are going to pray this prayer together in concert. Say this with me out loud. Oh God in heaven, I thank you for Jesus. I thank you that He died for me. And He's sitting at the right hand of the Father right now. Jesus, you are my Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, Lord, thank you, Lord. Oh, don't take this for granted. Such a sweet visitation of the Lord. Such a enveloping you right now. Go ahead, brother, just play that out loud. Go ahead, just go with that. Go with that. Family, whatever you get, just sing that to me. Thank you, Lord.
sweet to trust in Jesus. Just to take him at his word. Just to rest upon each promise. Just to know the Savior, the
preachers are getting, and I don't understand that. to his word, where it says that they were, in the last days, those that would heap upon themselves teachers and preachers, having itching ears, that, you know, they tickle the ear of what they want to hear. If you just send 1,000 and then all of a sudden all of your money problems go away. That's not always the case. But the thing is, we also know the other side, the imbalance is don't give anything. And we know nothing's coming in when you don't sow anything. 0 times 10 is 0. 0 times 100 is, yeah. But Lord, I want my harvest, meet my needs. But you know what? When you start looking at sowing how I started looking at it, it's worship. It's not a bill. Everybody in here knows what I'm talking about when I say you come to church on Sunday morning and they're passing the bucket or the plate. You know what I'm talking about, but you're like, ugh, feels like another bill. God ain't no bill, because bills don't return finances back to you. Glory to God, good measure, press down, shake together, running over. Man, get it back under your bosom. I'm telling you, we just, with the measure that you meet, the same measure comes back. Does anybody know what I mean by that? If I sow in $5 bills, I'll reap harvest of $5 bills. If I sow in $10 bills, I'll reap in increments of $10, and I've been there. I remember when it was a stretch that we were able to start giving 20 consistently. I was like, dear God, we've hit the lottery. And you know what? My goal has often been to increase that, to not just be a $20 giver, because to you that may be an extreme jump. But for somebody that's doing it, God wants them to go up to, you know, another level. You know, and that's the thing is, if I get more money to sow, that means a harvest must be coming in to allow me to have seed that day to sow. And here come the man in black. But I'm going to give you a key that's going to turn your life around financially. As you give to your church, as you give to this ministry tonight, we're taking up an offering for our ministry. You're sowing into good ground, but listen, don't just sow what you always sow. That was something that was so hard for Tammy and I to break out of, because it's easy. I got a $20 faith, and then it turned into $20 faith rut. Because everywhere I went, it didn't matter if they were good or not, $20. I'll take an envelope. Yes, could you write 20 on it? Thank you, because that's all I'm going to get them. And we get into a rut. I'll never forget when he told me to turn it into $100. I started buying and saving. I'm like, dear God, how is the enemy going to start talking to me in the middle of a church service like this? I bind you, Satan. God's not wanting you to go defeated in your finances. Number one, if you are, I encourage you to write these steps down. They're very simple. But I encourage you to write them down. Number one, don't always just sow what you sow. Now I'm talking about your tithe. That's different. Your tithe is 10%. We know what that is. You don't have to pray about it. You don't have to guess. We know. A dollar off of every 10. A dime off of every dollar. We know what that is. But I'm talking about above and beyond. Seed, offering. Wherein have you robbed me? In tithes and offerings. So we don't always teach that, but it's still the truth. But listen. The windows of heaven are opened over you already. Your seed releases the increase. Your obedience releases the increase. Offering time is not a time to say nevertheless, and then you drop your $1 bill net, and it breaks. You hear what I'm saying? So here's what I'm going to ask you to do. Do what I was taught by the Word and by God. Number one, don't always sow and just think, that's what I'm always going to sow. Ask Him, Lord, what would you have me to sow right now? And then obey. Secondly, after you get that amount, immediately tell the enemy, take your hands off of my finances in Jesus' name. Thirdly, commission the angels of God to go forth and cause your harvest to come immediately. Next, thank Him and don't waver. The money always comes. The money's always there. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Number one, don't always sow what you sow. Ask him, what do you want me to sow? Secondly, enemy, you take your hands off of my money. In Jesus' name. Thirdly, angels of God, go forth. Cause that money to come to me. I commission you to bring the harvest in immediately. And then praise him and thank him and don't wait. Those four easy steps have turned our life around. Has it always been easy? No, but it's so much easier now than it has been. Glory to God. We've had more blessings in the midst of a recession because I refuse to allow the enemy to campaign his junk in my life. Look at your neighbor and say, that's for you because you're not smiling. Hallelujah. Your peace and prosperity go hand in hand. You know when you got enough money to pay your bills, there's a weird peace that comes. But you know what? You're in control of it. You release it. You release your increase the moment that seed goes in the ground. So let's sing that again. Peace. I love that song. Let's sing that again. And as they sing it, let's bring it to the altar and let's sow it. And thank him. Don't go back there crying and saying, oh dear God, what did I do? You thank him. We thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. To trust in Jesus.
Anybody came in with pain? Who's got pain now and you wish you didn't have it? Well, we got a bunch of liars in this church tonight. All right, let's go. Liars, liars, and you know what's going to happen to your pants in a minute. Going to be in the hot seat. Ha! Glory to God. Hallelujah. Have you been having some ringing in your ear? Like there's almost like a, I don't know how to explain it, almost like a finger sometimes is in there. It's like some clogging. It has been you, hasn't it? I'm not trying to embarrass you, it's just sometimes we just get used to, you know, we're not even thinking that that's that big a deal, but glory to God. Brother, you have been soaking up the Word of God. Your ears are healed right now. Thank you. Ooh, whoa. Glory to God. Sorry for landing on you, sister. If you need a healing, you just got it anyway. Hallelujah. How's that doing now, brother? Do you feel something change in your ears? Yeah, like that. Just like something went like that. Like that, just released. Praise God. Hallelujah. That's a Holy Ghost high five right there. Oh, I didn't mean to mess your hair up. I love you, man. You know what? I'm just going to put you on blast tonight. You have got a serious call on your life. You've got such an important call that the Lord arrested me just now to tell you that it's time to get with Him more than you have been and seek Him more than you have been. Not that you don't love Him, that's not the issue, but I mean for specific strategies and what He's called you to do, specific routes that He's going to take you, and even before the end of the year, you're going to see things open up. There's going to be a fire that comes on you tonight that's going to burn you and launch you to that level. You're not going to be able to sleep some nights just because you know you got to get on this and do it and submit it to Him. Your pastor will help you get there. Glory to God. Woo! Thank you, Jesus. You were supposed to be here tonight. So glad you came. Jesus. Thank God. How did you hear about it? Artists. Thank you. Were you blessed? What did God do for you tonight? Because I saw the lights go on. You know what I mean? I saw where you're like, oh, another service. And I do this enough. I'm not offended. A lot of our preachers and teachers in this world have taught people to a stupor of not expecting. But I saw something just switch on your face where you're like, whew. What did He say to you? Yeah. Gave him more instruction to go higher. Yeah. That's so good. That is so good. What she said, if you didn't hear, is how Peter, when he came and fell down at the Master's feet, and just the love that God had for him, didn't condemn him for being a sinner or a sinful man. He gave him more instruction, told him not to fear, and he said, from this day forward, you will catch men. Ah, that's so good. I mean, that is great. He said, yeah, I'm glad you see it. And because you see it, because you acknowledge it, I'm opening you up for greater assignments. Oh man, that is the gift that keeps on giving. Revelation just keeps domino effecting. Not only did that man get to retire after he wondered where the food was coming from and the money was coming from, he not only got to retire, because he acknowledged where he was at humbly, God gave him even greater assignments. Man. Shouldn't have asked you. You got me preaching again. Well, you are blessed. I call you blessed. Do not miss Friday night. Somebody said, what's Friday night? Well, Friday night, 7 o'clock, night of worship, blowout, Holy Ghost, and Word meeting together. Healing, miracles, signs, wonders. Don't fight me. Come and get it. Thank you, Jesus. I keep getting drawn to you. I'm sorry. I tried to fight it. I keep getting drawn to you. Yeah, that's the ones that always look behind you. It's usually the one looking. Nobody else looked behind, but the one I was pointing at. Glory to God. It's not going to be how it's been. It ain't going to be all the junk and turmoil no more. Oh, glory to God. It's going to be so much better from this point. Listen, I know you love God. I know you trust God. But He's giving you affirmation right now. He is giving you a Holy Ghost affirmation highway that I'm telling you, it's not just going to be not how it's been. It's going to be such a drastic turn. You're going to be like, really? Really? Father, in Jesus' name, Holy Ghost turn around right there. No more, no more, no more. I rebuke and bind every single foul assignment. I break that in Jesus' name. Apparently that bears witness. And I don't know what you do, but I see a business and I see promotion and I see prosperity flooding you in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Yeah, that's why it's been a little difficult at times, because you've got to be, you're an entrepreneur, you are your own man. Yeah. You are a boss, that's why. Yeah, that's okay, but you got to learn how to submit so that you can learn how to lead and rule and reign. Thank you, Lord. Kingdom principles. Study everything there is about the kingdom of God in the Bible. Principles in there. Proverbs. Glory to God. You're already doing some of that. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Goodness. Woo! Thank you, Lord. You been having any pain in your back whatsoever?
I've been told that I've got degenerative disc disease. I've got fallen arches. So I've been told.
Sure.
And I just
yes, sir. I mean, you'll see me sometimes. I'll go and I'll put my hand on somebody's shoulder, but like three different times specifically tonight, I put hands on you. Three different times specifically. And that last time, I just popped you in the back. The Lord said, I'm healing his back. Ooh. Every one of those discs, every one of them, functioning to the perfection in which you created them to function, Lord. Ooh. Yeah. Arches, reform now. Brother, not to embarrass you, stand up. I'm showing you something here. Thank you, Lord. Go ahead and bend over now. All that stiffness gone. Go ahead, move around. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yeah. That's what the Lord said to me. He said, I'm healing his back. Like, have you been having problems with your back? Whew, what you gonna say? What you gonna say? You're gonna say, thank you, Lord. If he keeps us here until midnight, if we get out at 11:58, you will be out by 12. Wait, that's only on Sunday morning, right? Okay, I get it. Hallelujah. Circulation in your ankles is coming back. Hey, word of knowledge is one thing. Who's got a headache? That's one thing. But when you point at somebody and you're specific, your circulation is coming back. Good. Hey, thank you, Lord. To show y'all know what I'm talking about too, it's like, this seems like sometimes sitting even this long, seems like your feet would almost get kind of like a cold, like you almost have to have something wrapped around, like something warm to get them warm again. I'm telling you, God is healing that circulation. He did it 2,000 years ago right now. Amen. Glory to God. Come on, how many of y'all are asking God to forgive you for anything you've done in the last 24 hours right now? Hallelujah. Lord, forgive me. Forget it. You say you don't remember. Don't tell that crazy guy. Don't tell him. Let's lift our hands and just thank you one more time. Don't miss Friday night. If you miss Friday night, you're missing 3/4 of your life. And I know you respect your life more than that. Brother, your ear is completely healed and open now. Praise God. Peace. We love you, Lord. We glorify you. Pastor, anything I can say, or I just turn it over to you, sir?
We just want to make sure that everybody, I think this wish of heaven, the word, all that God is still there. It's needed to upgrade them out for Friday night and Sunday.
Yes.
We want to believe God for everybody that needs it.
Yes. If y'all know sick people, bring them. I mean, if you know people that need healing, bring them, miracles, bring them. We had a lady get up out of a wheelchair in New Hampshire 2 weeks ago. Praise God, yeah. We're expecting that kind of stuff. Seeing deaf ears open, blind eyes open. People diagnosed with bipolar completely healed. Both of them. I'm sorry. You tell me you better stop. All right. We've seen great miracles. AIDS healed, cancer healed, tumors disappear. Pastor, you'll like this. Creative miracles. Yes, sir. Did you see? We were like, whoa. A lady who had no female organs, had them removed because of a cancerous situation in her 20s, was still believing God that she would have children. We prayed for her, came back a year later. I didn't recognize her, brought her baby up to us. And said, would you dedicate our baby? South Texas, never forget that. And I said, well, wait a minute. You said you had a hysterectomy. She said, yes. But then he put the organs back in me, and I now have a baby. Creative. And that's not the only one. I mean, we've seen people that were born without kneecaps, God pop a knee in their with. What's this? Yeah, do you need one now?
I don't.
Yeah, somebody needs a kneecap. God will pop a kneecap on you. He'll bust a cap right in your leg.